What's up, everybody? I'm Justin, and you've stumbled upon my movie reaction channel. Today I'm going to be watching the 1993 A Bronx Tale starring Robert De Niro and a bunch of other people that I don't actually know because I am going into this completely blind. So, if you are new to the channel, welcome, and if you're returning, I am so happy to have you along for another ride. So this movie is, I know it's a Mafia movie, it was kind of like ranked in there around like Goodfellas and Casino, somewhere in that time frame there. I've seen Goodfellas and Casino, love those movies. I'm a fan of Robert De Niro, and I'm a fan of Joe Pesci, so I'm hoping that he shows up somewhere in this movie also. Though I don't think that's likely. If I remember correctly, the only three actual Mafia movies that Pesci was in were Goodfellas, Casino, and now The Irishman. I'm very interested in watching this. The Godfather was a favorite series of mine growing up. For anybody who's interested, there's actually a really interesting documentary on Netflix right now called Fear City. And this isn't a plug for Netflix or anything like that, but this documentary, it was incredibly interesting. It was about how the FBI and the district attorneys took down the Mafia in the 1970s and early 80s in New York City. It largely surrounds the Paul Castellano hit. But it was basically how they brought them down and how they took down the Mafia using RICO laws. So it was a very interesting documentary. It's a three-part documentary that really brings to light how bad it was in the Mafia. And they bring it on from both the district attorney and FBI's perspective and from former Mafia members' perspectives. So it's actually really interesting to see, and to be honest with you, I don't know how any of those Mafia guys on there didn't get whacked. Like, I have no idea. They just go on Netflix and start talking about Mafia secrets, like, whatever. So anyway, if you've made it this far, please hit that like button. If you want to keep coming back to my channel, I'm slowly growing my library, but, you know, if you want to keep checking me out, you like the sound of my voice or whatever, hit that subscribe button so that you know when I drop new videos. Let's get into it. It's a nice melody. Sounds good. Nice little quartet. Might be choir. I can't tell.
That's Mount Carmel Church. And the sound of the bells would fill the neighborhood.
I live down the road from a church, and I love hearing the church bells every Sunday. I'm not a very pious man, but I love that sound.
The New York Yankees were playing the Pittsburgh Pirates in the World Series, and Mickey Mantle was like a god to me. My dad would take me to Yankee Stadium, and we would watch the Yankees win.
Back when they were good.
That's the Shea Beepy. That's where all the guys hung out. But I'll tell you about them later.
That's like in the Goodfellas. Frankie Capone. Nicky No-Nos.
And on warm summer nights, all through the neighborhood, you would hear the sounds of young Italian men romancing their women.
Hey, Marie! Get in the fucking car!
No!
Get in the car!
Maria!
Leave me alone.
You know, baby. You know I love you.
Yeah, bullshit.
Will you get in the fucking car?
And right there under that lamppost there stood the man, the number one man in the neighborhood, Sonny.
Sonny, okay. Sonny's the boss. But is he the capo? Is he the capo regime, or is he the godfather? Or is he just the leader of a crew?
No, we ain't giving no hope. I ain't Romeo and no hold. Making a party, chocolate Barbie, waiting on me for
you. What do you want, man?
You got room there for us.
Cat calling the girls at the red light. Alright, so I don't care what anybody says. Connecticut has the best pizza anywhere in the United States. New York, no competition. Connecticut has the best. And none of that Frank Pepe's garbage. There's 100 better places than Frank Pepe's. If you ever come to Connecticut, Don't let anybody say, oh, Pepe's has the best pizza. They burn the bottom all the time. I hate it.
Oh,
so De Niro is a city employee. He is not a gangster in this movie. A little Frankie, a little Sinatra, who also had questionable ties to the Mafia. I had heard that the scene in The Godfather where the cousin is a singer, I forget his name in the movie, Johnny Fontaine. The scene where Johnny Fontaine comes to The Godfather asking to be put in that movie, I heard was based on something that happened with Frank Sinatra. I don't know if it's true. We could try looking it up when this is over.
Closure, your father wants to talk to you.
About what, Dad?
Your mother told me she caught you by the bar today.
I was by the bar.
Tell your father the truth.
I was by the bar.
So then why'd you lie?
I took a shot.
Want to do something here?
I took a shot. There you go, kid. That's right. Something about to get whacked.
Fuck you, you freeho. Yeah. Fuck you, you scumbag. You're a real
here we go.
Your fucking head. I'm gonna bust your fucking head.
There it is.
Sonny, give me the gun.
I think he got him the first time he got hit in the head.
When Sonny looked at me for the first time, I went deaf. I couldn't hear. All I could see was Sonny with the gun in his hand.
That must have been some shit for a little kid to see. Now he's gonna yell that for his racism. That's right, you little mongrel.
Okay, good. I'm Detective Belsick. This is my partner, Detective Bella. Hello, son. How you doing, ma'am? I'd like to ask your son a few questions.
About what?
There was a shooting in front of the building a little while ago, and we believe your son was there.
Really? Well, he don't know nothing about that.
Yeah, that literally just happened. These are mafia guys. That literally just happened. Even New York, where there's a cop on every corner, that it's not that quick that detectives get there. With all the people on the street who needed to see, who saw what happened, they needed this little boy to come down and identify the mobsters.
How about this guy? Is it him?
This is rough. For his own life, he should be saying no right now. I think he's smart enough. He's gonna say no.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, we fooled him.
So,
I didn't rat.
In the time it took him to go downstairs, get his son, go upstairs, ask his son what happened, and lock the door. Detectives showed up, already had suspects, and they didn't question anybody on the street. That part of the movie doesn't hold up for me.
Come on, Sonny wants to see you. Come on. Come on, nobody's gonna grab that bike. Come on.
Didn't your parents ever tell you not to go away with strangers like that? The hell? Ugh, that water is cloudy. What is that? Is that lemonade? I hope it's lemonade and not water. But even if it's lemonade, that's still the wrong color. I know lemonade, real lemonade isn't yellow, but that's still the wrong color. Something to play
with. Go and find yourself. We finally got our own social club.
It is a great song.
We called the Deuces Wild. Drinks were a buck, and the jukebox and the cigarette machine paid the rent.
Oh, that's the guy that played the young Joe Pesci character in Goodfellas, the kid in the brown suit. It's amazing. He kind of looks like De Niro. He looks like he could be De Niro's kid.
Dad, do we have to listen to this music? It gives me a headache.
Hey, you kids today, I gotta tell you, you don't even know what good music is. Listen to this. This is good music.
It's like every adult talking to every child. You guys don't know what new good music is today.
rice with me tomorrow night?
See something he likes. She sees something she likes.
This guy Louis Dumps over here, you know, he owes me $20. It's been 2 weeks now, and every time he sees me, he keeps dodging me. Yeah. He's becoming a real pain in the ass. I mean, should I crack him on or what?
What's the matter with you? What have I been telling you? Sometimes hurting somebody ain't the answer. First of all, is he a good friend of yours?
Nah, I don't even like him.
You don't even like him? Well, there's your answer right there. Look at it this way. It costs you $20 to get rid of him, right? He's never going to bother you again. He's never going to ask you for money again. He's out of your life for $20. You got off cheap. Forget it.
You're always right. You're always right.
Yeah.
That's a good way to look at it. Yeah, you got him out of your life for $20.
What's wrong with the way we're dressed?
Stop. This gentleman ain't dressed. Trying to ask them to leave.
Step a few beers. That's it.
That's it. We'll be on our way.
You got some booze down here. Nice cold ones. Get us some nice cold ones.
He handed it very diplomatically.
If I may.
Yeah, see, here's how you get kicked out. This is how you get your ass killed.
Now you just can't leave.
Jojo! He's pulling out some, Umaga.
I shall wrestling. Never love another.
I'm sorry, I keep fidgeting in my chair, folks. Alright. As a person who owns a Harley, that is painful to watch. Very painful.
Take a look at this gun right here.
Colt 1911.
45. Stinker stomp a fucking elephant driving a truck and the truck too.
Nicky's here was a neighborhood thief.
Check it out.
His mother called him.
Oh, and trigger discipline is terrible. Get your finger off the trigger. Oh, God, everybody.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Don't point the gun, Nicky.
God, on safety. What am I going to kill you guys?
Dude, he's got the hammer pulled back with his trigger on the finger. Or his finger on the trigger. There's nothing that drives me more crazy than seeing bad trigger discipline, especially in movies, because young people are watching these movies and they think it's cool to hold a gun and not treat it like it's loaded. Always treat a gun like it's loaded and never put your finger on a trigger unless you're planning on doing something terrible. And now when I say something terrible, when you use that gun, it's terrible. Even if you're justified for using it, it's still a terrible action that's happening. Don't put your finger on the trigger and don't point the gun at anything that you don't intend on killing. Period. Always treat the gun like it's loaded.
He's been ducking me for 2 weeks. When I see him, I'm gonna fucking break his face. Like
high school? Yeah.
He's a fucking jerk. $10.
High school or college?
He's out of your life. I'm still gonna fucking break his face. Between this guy and fucking home, I'm fucking proud.
It's the girl from the bus.
I couldn't believe it. There she was, right in front of me. I never forgot her since the first day I saw her on my father's bus. I wanted to talk to her, but she was with her friends and I was with mine.
Well, he really can't keep his eyes off her. He really likes her.
If it's no problem, I could walk you home.
Okay. I live down Webster Avenue. Is that all right?
That's no problem.
Yeah, it's a good first meeting, I think. I think he's doing all right.
I don't know.
Ooh, Knights in White Satin? Ooh. That's a song I haven't heard in a while. I like it.
What the fuck,
I don't know,
man?
If I can put that in here, though.
They ain't bothering nobody.
They fucking bothering me.
They ain't bothering me.
Ah, oh, come on. Like, I realized this was a struggle then. That they did shit like this. Crazy. For no other reason than skin color. Just. It's never the measure of the man, you know what I mean? It's the skin color. It's fucking stupid. They picked such a great song for such a stupid scene. Like, they could have picked anything else.
Let me tell you something. When you're alone late at night in bed, just you and her under the covers, that's all that matters, see? You gotta do what your heart tells you to do. Let me tell you something right now. You're only allowed 3 great women in your lifetime. They come along like the great fighters once every 10 years. Rocky Marciano, Sugar Ray Robinson, Joe
Lewis. What is he doing? Why is he driving backwards?
Sometimes, girl, she pull wind.
Is he driving backwards so he can go the wrong way on the one-way streets? Is that what just happened?
Maybe she's your friend.
Oh, what happened when you were Sonny?
Nothing.
I
don't
talk. Where'd
you get this car?
Hey, don't worry about it. We borrowed it.
Slow the fuck down. I don't want to get...
These guys are going to go do something stupid now.
I'm not driving.
With the way they're driving.
You're fucking flying.
Oh, it's stolen. Cool.
You teach those motherfuckers a lesson.
They throw eggs, so now these guys come and throw Molotovs. There's a difference between vandalism or criminal mischief and arson, which is what they're about to do.
See, out of the car.
Sonny, come on, he's with us.
Mind your business, you. See, out of the car.
Sonny, come on, he's with us.
Dumbass. The boss told you to shut up.
I want to be with you, and I don't care what anybody says. Can I have a kiss?
Get it, Collagino. Collagino? Collagino?
My brother didn't mean.
Your brother! Where's your car? Give me the keys. Come on, we gotta go.
Oh, the Molotovs.
What are you talking about?
Those kids are about to do something stupid. Oh, shit! Oh, they're shooting, too!
In the wilderness!
These kids are all about to get whacked. Sonny's gonna whack them all now. They're doing shit without permission from the boss. Oh shit! Oh, they're whacking themselves. Dumbasses. Dumbasses. That's what you get. That's what you get. You didn't know what the hell you were doing. You weren't doing it for the right reason. You got exactly what you had coming.
What's going on? What's happening?
Four white guys just got blown up. Five boys just got
killed. Okay. They said that very aggressively.
All I could see was these big smiling faces. All of a sudden, out of all these smiling faces, there was this one face. I couldn't understand why I kept looking at this one face, and then I realized why. He wasn't smiling.
Is he gonna whack Sonny? Wow.
How you doing, Sonny? Not so good, huh? I want to thank you for saving my life. I never got a chance to tell you. They all died. Slick, Aldo, Mario, Ralphie.
Yeah, they were no good for you, man. Sonny knew that. It's Joe Pesci, all right!
Thinking out loud. It's okay. You don't remember me, do you? Many years ago.
Oh, he's the dude that was getting hit with the bat in the car.
You don't remember this? Yeah, the baseball bat. You were the guy that got hit with the baseball bat, right? Sonny and my father always said that when I get older, I would understand. Well, I finally did. I learned something from these two men. I learned to give love and get love unconditionally. Okay. You just have to accept people for what they are. And I learned the greatest gift of all. The saddest thing in life is wasted talent. And the choices that you make will shape your life forever. But you can ask anybody from my neighborhood, and they'll just tell you, this is just another Bronx tale.
And there's the movie title. All right, so that was 1993's A Bronx Tale. It was really good. I enjoyed the movie a lot. I'm going to go out with a rating right off the bat. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. It was definitely a good movie.
Definitely something I would watch again and recommend it to friends. I really appreciated the cinematic style. It was heavily reminiscent of Goodfellas, the way, you know, they took it from the little kid growing up. What I did like, though, it was the antithesis of Goodfellas. In Goodfellas, he grew up and wanted to stay in the life. In A Bronx Tale, he's growing up, he's finding out what the life is like and doesn't want to stay in it. Which I think was great, you know, and a lot of familiar faces, some faces from Goodfellas. You got De Niro. We ended up seeing Joe Pesci at the end. That was great. I thought that was amazing. Well, so anyway, this has been a great movie. I really enjoyed watching it. It was a little over 2 hours, and I didn't even feel like I hit that 2 hour mark. Again, I've been Justin. You've been a great audience. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can hit the bell notification if you want to know exactly when I'm dropping movies. I try to put them out every couple days or so. That's going to be a trend I try to stick with. Thanks again for coming for the ride. See you on the next one.